I'm gonna take the bearings off of this thing, and I've seen a lot of people cut the cages on these bearings and then slice the inner race and then punch it with a chisel until they break, but I didn't feel like doing that. And also, I wanted to potentially save these bearings for not on this side, but on my pinion side. I wanted to save them for mock-up, but I ended up getting this tool. Here it is. Oh, it is the puller for this bearing, and it's a clamshell that caps together, and then you tighten up this collar around it, and then there is a bolt, essentially, that then goes down to a shaft that pushes on the center of that and pulls it up off of it. So we'll go ahead and pull this off, and I'll show you guys the process, but it's pretty neat. This thing works like a charm. So there's a lot of videos on this, but I'll show you the process. It comes with a couple different pieces, a couple different shapes. This thing's $100 on Amazon. I think it's, like, the brand is a Vivor. They're starting to make a bunch of shit. But these clamshells, there's a wide open side and a more narrow side. They slide over that bearing, just like that. Same thing on the other side, like that. But before you put them together, there is the actual tool. A lot of pieces, but we'll just unscrew that nut so that this shaft has enough clearance in there. And then we'll put these jaws on there. They're pretty tight underneath that bearing, so you kind of got to get them set where you need them and slide this collar down around it, and you'll get it. You can get them to get to go down around there, and it'll clamp in. Tighten up that nut, tighten up the bolt, take the play out of it so it presses on there square. And then let me back you guys up. And then you use your nice chrome 1.5-inch socket to pull it off there, and have a impact socket for this 1.5-inch. But this will be fine for just this one. Here's our carrier. That bearing pulled off there. Don't have to worry about nicking or cutting the end of that carrier bearing surface like you would have to if you were to cut that bearing off. You'd end up having to be real careful to not nick this surface at all, but with this tool, it just pulls it right off. We'll take this ring off there here in a minute, and just strip this thing down, get it ready for ring and bearings. Okay, so I got my ring gear off the carrier. I'm gonna go ahead and press off this last bearing, and then we'll clean everything up, get our old parts out of there, get the new ring gear out here. We'll just surface this real quick and make sure that it's nice and smooth, and get that new ring gear on the carrier and be ready to go. So one second, I'll take the bearing off the carrier. Okay, I got that second bearing off. I was sure to, when I did it this time, I was sure to get this plate nice and as well under this as I could. It's not a perfect circle, and this is the smallest one they offer. There's, I should mention, this kit for $100 comes with 3 different sizes of these, and then 3 different collars. So there it is. It's all off. That tool is a lifesaver. You can have those things off in 2 minutes. Okay, so I'm putting new bearings on my carrier. And obviously these are a press fit. They don't fit on without a press or without somehow expanding that inner race. So it'll fit on the carrier. There's 2 of these. There's one on this side and obviously one down here on the other side as well, so that this can spin independently. And the way that I'm going to get this on, you can probably see in the background my little air fryer pizza oven thing. And we'll do we'll go actually tempted to go bake. That way I can actually set the temp, because I want this temp set to 450. We'll go ahead and start. And we're going to put those bearings in there now, and then we'll pop them on. And while those are baking, I will put just a little bit of gear oil on here so that it's not going on there dry and doesn't want to stick on there. We'll put just a little bit of gear oil on, and then hopefully if all goes right, I'll be able to just drop it right down in place. There are no shims on the inside of the carrier. The way that these carriers are shimmed left to right is shims on the outside of the bearing cap. And for extra measure, I'll just throw this carrier in here.